On December 15th, when the Kaio Pariko DLC releases for GT Online, imagine this is what happens. That would be pretty freaking sweet, wouldn't it? Now, that was a little clip made by, as you can see, or as you saw from the watermark, Moore's Mutual. I'll leave a link to his Reddit post in the description. You can check it out. It's a pretty simple idea, though, but honestly, I think it would benefit a lot of people in GTA Online. Now, we still don't even technically know if this island is going to be in free mode or if it's just going to be a heist-only island. But for the sake of this video, let's say it will be coming to free mode. If it comes to free mode, then there's probably two ways Rockstar go about adding it to the game. They either add it as an island just off the coast somewhere, which, if you think about it, wouldn't really make much sense logically. If this island is like a drug cartel island in the middle of the ocean, it wouldn't make much sense that it's right off the coast of Los Santos. So we can just throw that idea out. The other alternative is what you just saw, where you would go to an airport or a dock area, pay for a ticket. I'm sure Rockstar will make us spend money, like 100K or 500K or something like that. You would have a little cutscene where you're on a boat or on a plane, like you saw, and then you would show up on the island, probably at the airport or the dock, probably not inside of a building like the guy had, but whatever the case may be, it would be as simple as that. And the reason this could be the best idea Rockstar's ever added to GTA Online is because it would solve a lot of the problems people have with free mode. This island could be a safe space. It could be a safe haven from all the BS of online, of free mode. In this hypothetical, obviously, when we take the cutscene to the other island, it would put us in sort of a new instance of GTA Online. I think Rockstar could make it so where you're in the same free mode lobby, so if you hit the character player list, you would see everyone in it. You just wouldn't be able to obviously interact with the people on the main island unless you traveled back. Now, before we even get any further, the one downside of that is you might split the player base between the islands, so there might not be as much people on the main island because a lot of people are going to be on this newer island. But honestly, with next gen consoles being released and hopefully the enhanced version of the game coming out sometime next year, Rockstar could potentially upgrade and bump the player count from 32 or 30 to like 48 or even 64. So that could relieve some of the issues, but that's really the only downside to this idea I had. Now, the benefit of this island being instanced is Rockstar could change the rules of free mode. Now, you wouldn't be able to do, let's say, business missions because your businesses aren't on this island. You wouldn't be able to do certain like VIP missions and jobs because, again, that stuff's not on this island. So this would be sort of a bare bones back to the old school way of things island. And that would help so many people. If when you come to this island, the game treats it logically, so you wouldn't have access to any of your vehicles. Moore's Mutual, Johnny on the spot, you can't fly across an ocean, you know what I mean, and deliver you a car. So it wouldn't make sense for you to have that on this island, which could lead to some very cool things. Also, because of that, and we'll dive deeper into the mechanic and all that in a minute, but because of no vehicles, no player-owned vehicles on this island, you wouldn't have Oppressor Mark IIs, you wouldn't have Deluxos, you wouldn't have, let's say, like Orbital Strikes. It's not a vehicle, but you wouldn't have any of this crazy OP stuff on this island. That's one of the main complaints people have with free mode. Imagine you had a place to go and hang out with friends where you didn't have to worry about dying. You didn't have to worry about being blown up. That would be so refreshing. I can't even explain how I want this to happen now. Now, of course, with no vehicles being able to be spawned on this island, you may be wondering, well, how we're going to get around. So obviously you have the choice of, you know, stealing cars, old school GTA 4 stuff, right? You steal a car off the street. There you go. What Rockstar could do though is add like a garage or two and island specific vehicles that you can purchase. So let's say the Jeep we saw in the trailer, let's say you could purchase that for like, I don't know, 250K or something like that. And that's a vehicle you have access to when you're on this island. So they could have island specific accessible vehicles. Of course, hopefully none of those vehicles would be weaponized. It would just be normal freaking vehicles. So you could go back to the old school style of GTA. Another benefit of this island could be no cops. We all know cops in GTA are so annoying. They just get in the way of fun. Imagine you now have a place to go to mess around with your friends where you don't have to worry about the police. And it works logically. The LSPD wouldn't be on this island in the middle of nowhere. Now, if Rockstar wanted to, they could just have like gang attack areas and places like that where the drug cartel members of the island can attack you. So there is some PvE aspects there, but no more shooting your gun in the middle of nowhere and a cop shows up. That could be one of the main features of this island. Of course, there's going to be the heist on this island, but in free mode, you're probably not going to be able to do the heist. So what if they added some sort of old school jobs, some old school missions to this island, just to give you some things to do in free mode? Wouldn't be much, but just some little things scattered around so you at least had something to do on this island besides just mess around with friends. I'm sure there would be even more stuff you guys can come up with in the comment section, but those are kind of the main selling points, at least for me, for why Rockstar should have this island be sort of an instance thing where you have to go to the airport and, let's say, buy a ticket to be able to go to it. I think it would give people the best of both worlds. You can do your business stuff, make money, do all the normal things in Los Santos, but if you just wanted to get away from it all, you could take a vacation, right, to Cayo Perico, where you didn't have to worry about cops, you didn't have to worry about griefers, where you just drive around and relax in a public free mode lobby. That sounds like such an awesome thing for GTA Online that I really hope Rockstar don't miss out on allowing us to have that. Now, if this island doesn't release in free mode at the start, that's something we should push for. We should ask Rockstar, hey, make this something we can add in free mode if we get a ticket or if we go to the airport and take a cutscene there. Like I said at the beginning, that would make way more sense than just having the island be off the coast of Los Santos. And as for like the ticket prices, because of course, like, Rockstar are gonna make you pay for it if they did this. Once you finish the heist, maybe they discount it. Like moving the yacht around, that's only 10K now. So let's say the normal price is 100K, but once you complete the heist, let's say it is only 10K. I would gladly spend $10,000 to go into an instance version of the same session I'm in without griefers, without cops, so I could just relax in GTA Online. I wouldn't have to go into passive mode. I wouldn't have to constantly be checking my map. And if I did have people trying to grief, what's the worst they could do? Throw a sticky bomb at me like the olden early days of GTA Online? I'll take that over lock-on missiles any day. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Check out more of the Reddit post. Like I said, link to it is in the description. It's just a simple idea, but man, it would make GTA Online so much better. If you have anything you want to add to this idea, of course, let us know as well in the comments. But thank you all for watching. That's going to do it for this video. Please drop a like if you did enjoy. Subscribe for more GTA content. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.